ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، وبسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد يسرنا القرآن للذكر فهل من مدكر. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome to our 24th session where the journey with the verbs continues. SubhanAllah, in the past week I received a couple of messages saying how do we remember all of this? Are there any tips and tricks that we can use? Or it's getting overwhelming. I understand verbs is the place where things become a little bit challenging, but trust me, it is doable. It is more than doable. You will breeze through it once you figure out certain tricks and tips. All right, and we're going to spend some time doing that. Now, one of the suggestions was that if I give the work or the chart that we are going to work on the following week, if I can give it ahead of time so everybody can review. I love that idea, right? So that you're prepared to come to class. So what I did was I gave you basically all the charts for Mazid Fihi, right? And the document is uploaded in the description box. Here it is. If you take a look at this, Afrin, if you can please pull up the doc on the screen. So you have the Mazid Fihi verbs in the description box. All right, this basically lists all the groups, all right, that we have done so far and everything that we are going to be covering. All right, so it has up to group 10. All the charts are here. Today we are going to cover group 3. Okay, here, let me show you group 3. So here, we're going to do group 3 today. All right, and you have the next group, which is, and remember I told you it doesn't go in order, right? This is the only place where the order breaks. Then we have group 5. All right, so this is something that we will be covering next class, and I just have provided you with the chart so you can take a look at it, and that way you become familiar with it. All right, that's a very good idea, and it really shows how hard you're working, and you know you really want this. And subhanallah, the only thing is for you to want it. Trust me, when you want it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. He will grant you. This is what He is going to make easy for you. And like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, and every time I start off the lesson with this, لَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِذِكْرٍ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. We have made it easy for remembrance. Are there anyone out there who's going to take that chance, who's going to make that effort? So definitely you are from the ones who's making that effort. Keep going, keep growing. Inshallah, you're almost at the finish line, all right? So inshallah today, like I said, so this is the document that has all the charts in it. And the other, there's another resource that all of you can access. It is called Lisan al-Quran. It's an excellent book in terms of like, there's so much exercise in it, like for practice, and it also has a key. So that's the best part. And it's available online, PDF, right? So it's Lisan al-Quran. After class, inshallah, I'll put it in the comment section so you can go search it. There's volume 1, there's volume 2. So volume 2 actually has all the verbs, right? The mujarrad verbs and the mazid fihi verbs. Every group is taken by itself. It is a lesson by itself, and then there are multiple exercises just practicing them. Certain ones you will be able to breeze through, and certain ones you will have a hard time, and that's only because you've not been exposed to everything yet in terms of maybe the particles that come with verbs. That still remains, and inshallah we'll do that right at the end. Once we finish the groups, then we have very few particles, and it's very simple, right, that come with verbs. We'll do them right when we finish group 10, inshallah. All right, so you will see how particles affect the verbs. So keep in mind that today I'm going to give you some tips to recognize, all right? And the other thing is Lisan al-Quran. You can look up Lisan al-Quran, and you can practice, and you can check your answers with the answer key as well, all right? So here, let me go to the second document, which is the lesson for today itself. Now, in the last lesson, and thank you again for pointing this out, there was a typo in this, right? In group 5, where I had made a mistake, okay? So in this one, I corrected it, all right? I said ifta'ala yafta'ilu tafa'ulan. That's basically what I had in the last, in the last document will show that, but this is basically what the correct one is. Tafa'ala yatafa'alu tafa'ulan. Alright, so that's group 5. We're not doing that today. We are doing this today. Right, group 3. Fa'ala yufa'ilu fi'alan. So the masdar are two here. Okay, there is fi'alan and mufa'alatan. Okay, so this is what you need to memorize. Fa'ala yufa'ilu madi mudari, and the masdar is fi'alan aw mufa'alatan. And there are so many common examples, like you can just plug, you know, it'll be easy for you to plug into them, inshallah. So here, what I did next was, if you look at the document that I gave you for Mazid Fihi, take your time to go over it after the lesson is over. It's all there for you. I have basically listed out for you. This is the document that has all the Mazid Fihi verbs, right? So I have listed out for you every, the difference between each group in terms of like additions, right? What are the additions? Why does it fall under the Mazid Fihi group? In addition to Fa, Ayn, and Lam, the three root letters, right? In addition to the three root letters, and then you have the markers of Mudare, which come at the end, right? You have the markers of Mudare, and then you have the markers of, markers of Mudare that come in the beginning and at the end, Atain, right? And then you have the markers of Madi. In addition to those, and in addition to Fa, Ayn, and Lam, there is something else that is extra that makes it Mazid Fihi. So we see in group 4, alright, it Madi has a Hamza, this is the extra. Okay, so you see Aslama, it is Madi, Seen, Lam, and Neem. Okay, and the Hamza is extra, and the Mudare begins with a Dhamma. When the Mudare begins with a Dhamma, alright, and this is like 99% of the times, okay, when the mudare begins with a dhamma, it is a mazid fihi verb. Okay, you just have to figure out whether it's mazid fihi group 4, whether it's group 2 or group 3. These are the three mazid fihi families that have their mudare beginning with dhamma. After that, there's no dhamma in the mudare. Okay, so these are the tips. You see, like, you Yuslimuna, Yu'minuna, Yuqinuna, right? All these, they begin with a Dhamma, alright? And you see the three root letters after that. For example, if you see Yu'minuna, okay? Yu'minuna, I'm going to write it down over here so it's easier for you to follow, okay? If I write Yu'minuna, okay? So first thing, I have identified this as my verb, right? Once I have identified it as a verb, now I know that this is mudare. Why do I know it's mudare? Because it has a ya in the beginning, okay? So I'm going to get rid of my mudare markers. So I get rid of the ya in the beginning, okay? And then I get rid of the waw and the noon because it's part of the scale. Remember, it tells us that it's plural. So whatever remains, okay, you have hamza, meem, and noon. 1, 2, 3. These are the three root letters, okay? Three root letters. Mudare begins with a dhamma. What does it belong to? Group 4. Okay, simple. Now let me take another one for you. For example, if we write yusabbihuna, okay, let me erase this bit for you, okay, so it doesn't become too crowded here. Okay, so now let me write this one, yusab, okay, yusabbihuna, okay, yusabbihuna. Now if I say yusabbihuna again, I have to first figure out whether it's a verb or a noun. Of course, this is a verb over here. When I have identified it as a verb, is it mujarrad or is it mazid fihi? Because it begins with a dhamma, okay? Because it begins with a dhamma, has a O-E sound, yusabbi, right? Yu-mi or yu-ki, because it has a O-E sound, has to be mazid fihi, okay? Now, I have identified it as mazid fihi. If it is mazid fihi, which group does it belong to? All right, begins with a dhamma. All right, so now I'm gonna eliminate. I'm gonna do my elimination. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of my ya, which is the mudare. Okay, and then I get rid of my waw. I get rid of the ta, noon. Sorry. Okay, and then what am I left with? I'm left with seen, ba, ha. These are the three root letters. What is extra? There is a shad that is extra. So when you have a shad that is extra, that is group 2. Okay, so this is simple. You just, and this is so common in the Quran, right? You will immediately recognize it. And if it was like Madi, then let me do a Madi one for you. Hold on. Sorry. Here. Okay. A Madi one will look like this. Okay. Here. You have, sorry. Sabbahu. Say Sabbahu. Okay. Sabbahu lillahi. All right. Sabbahu. So now, it's Madi, right? Because it does not have attain, so it has to be Madi. All right. Now in Madi, I'm going to get rid of whatever's part of the scale. What is part of the scale? The waw and the alif is part of the scale. I have one, two, three. Seen, ba, ha. Is there anything extra? Yes, there is a shad over here. And which group has shad as an addition to it? That is group two. All right, so it belongs here. The second root letter will carry a shad. So it's a second root letter. So these are things, these are tricks and these are tips. Let's look at the third one that we're going to be doing today, group three, right? So here, the extra letter is alif, not hamza. Big difference, okay? The extra letter is alif, okay? And the mudari begins with a dhamma and it will also show the alif, all right? So here, let's go ahead and do an example, okay? Here. Okay, so I'm going to write, for example, here, if I write jahada, okay, jahada, jahada, sorry, jahada, jahada, jahadu, jahadat, jahadata, jahadna, jahatta, jahattuna, jahattum, jahatti, jahattuna, jahattunna, jahattu, jahadna, jahadna. So the alif continues throughout the chart and you have it in your notes. It's there. It's there. Don't worry about it, okay? The entire group three chart is there. Just follow along with me right now. So the addition over here, so if you look at it, okay, if you look at it, this is jim, which is the first root letter. Ha, second root letter, and dal is the third root letter. What is extra? It's the alif that is extra, and that is going to show. All right, how is it mudari going to look like? Jahada, and the mudari begins with dhamma. These are the three groups, all right, four, two, and three. They begin with dhamma, so we'll say yuja, okay, yujahidu. Okay, so now when I have yujahidu, all right, when I have yujahidu, say it came somewhere and I came across it in the Quran or some text, right? The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to eliminate to figure out what is the root letter, right? So eliminate what I know. Eliminate what are the markers for mudari. Eliminate the ya dhamma, okay? Is there anything else that I can eliminate from here? From the ending, there is nothing, right? So I just eliminate the ya dhamma. The ya dhamma tells me, ooh, yujahidu. See, I told you, ooh, e sound, okay? That's constant through 4, 2, and 3. Ooh, e sound. Muslimu. Aslama, yuslimu. Ooh, e, all right? Then you have fa'ala, yufa'ilu. Ooh, e. Then you have fa'ala, yufa'ilu. Ooh, e. So this ooh, e sound, you need to keep a listen for that. Okay, so yujahidu, get rid of the ya dhamma, all right? And then let's try and count the root letters. We have jim, okay, and then we have ha, and then we have dal. So 1, 2, 3, these are the root letters. What is extra? The extra is alif. When I have figured out what the extra is, now I know it belongs to mazid fihi, group three. See, the beauty about learning Quran, right? To learning Arabic, to understand Quran, is that the text is already punctuated, okay? This will build you up for text that is not punctuated. And when I mean not punctuated, meaning text that does not have fatha, dhamma, kasra, like if you go to the hadith book and sometimes they have the punctuation, sometimes they don't have the punctuation. The explanation, the sharah never has the punctuation. And even the tafsir of the ayahs, right? We have all these classical tafsir books that don't have punctuation. So at that time, of course, you're going to apply all of this. But with the Quran, the punctuation is already there. So half your job is done. The only thing that you have to do is recognize, okay? And how you recognize, we go through an elimination process, and I have listed that in your document today, okay? Here it is. This is very important. You go through an elimination process anytime you see a word. So what I'm going to do is, like, and last week we started application with Surah Ra'd, right? And we did Ayah 1. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to pick something from the Ayah 1 of Surah Ra'd itself. Okay, today we're going to do the second one, inshallah. So say, for example, I'm going to pick Al-Kitabi. Okay, I'm going to pick Al-Kitabi and I want to figure out what kind of a word it is. So I'm going to write Al-Kitabi. Of course, you know, but just to help you go through this, using it as an example, help you go through the elimination process. Okay, so Al-Kitabi. Number one, is it a noun? How do I know if it is a noun or not? Look for Alif Lam. Okay, look for Tanween. Does it have Alif Lam? Yes, it has Alif Lam. Okay, remember, sometimes Alif Lam is part of the root. Yani, it's part of the spelling. Okay, but those are exceptions. Standard rule is that Alif Lam, the noun comes attached with Alif Lam if it's proper. Okay, so I have Alif Lam. All right. Automatically, I know it is a noun. All right. The next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to do my TGNS. If you have been following right from day one, you know what TGNS stands for. Type, gender, number, status, right? So you're going to do all the properties of the noun. And then what you're going to identify is it a mujarrad noun or mazid fihi noun? Skip that process now. Okay. You will become very familiar with it. Trust me. See, mazid fihi nouns, okay, they follow a standard pattern. You know the masdar. For example, afa'ala, yuf'alu, if'alan. That's a noun, okay? Then you have mufa'ilun, mufa'alun. So they follow a standard pattern. You know, if it's mim dhamma, okay, most of the times if it's mim dhamma, 99% of the times it is mazid fihi. So there you go. It's not that you just identify mujarrad and mazid fihi in the case of verbs only. Mujarrad and mazid fihi is identified for nouns also, because we have nouns in those families also. It's not just madhi and mudhari, right? So here, when you look at a word, you need to identify whether it plugs into any of those scales. Does it sound like ifa'alan, mufa'ilun, mufa'alun? Does it sound like tafa'ilun, mufa'ilun, mufa'alun? Okay, and today what we will do with group 3. Does not sound like any of those, right? It's mujarrad. Okay? It's mujarrad. And dictionary will also give you. Okay? So there's nothing to worry there. And if you don't figure it out, it's not a problem. All you need to know is like what the meaning is. Okay? So here, Al-Kitab, you do the TGNS, and then you know that Alif Lam is part of the scale, right? And the root is what? Kaf, Ta, and Ba. Alif is part of the scale. All right? Now, and then you go ahead, you look for the meaning in the dictionary, and you translate. Now, someone may say, well, you said Alif is part of Mazid Fihi verb. This is not a verb. Okay? Because it has Alif Lam in the beginning. And keep in mind, Mazid Fihi nouns, they follow a certain patterns also. So you have just the presence of an Alif somewhere does not automatically indicate that it belongs to Mazid Fihi group 3. Okay? So you have to do those checks in your mind, and it comes with practice. It's like algebra. Alright? You can understand the concept really well, but if you don't practice, you're not going to go anywhere. So same here. It's no different. And listen, everything good in life, it requires effort. This is the best thing. This is ibadah for you, right? So regardless of the struggle that you're going through, how many times, like, or how many instances in our life we experience where we're rewarded for our struggle. This is the only place where we are rewarded for our struggle. For even failing, we're rewarded. Failing is not even counted. Failing is taken as rahmah. It draws rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where else will you get this? So this is your motivation. This is your reason for keep going with this journey, inshallah. Okay? So here, if it's a noun, So there are 3 checks. There's the A check, there's the B check, and then there's the C check. If I don't identify it as a noun, then I move on to check if it's a particle. Okay? And I know, fi, bi, ila, hiya, anna, lakinna. Particles have a certain look. And there is a list, right? You have the list of particles. You have the jar majrur particles, and then you have the nasab mansub particles, right? The particles of nasab. Do they fit into that list? Something less than like maybe 20, all right? Does it fit into that list? If it doesn't fit into that list, then it's not a particle. Move on. And now you have to check if it's a verb. If the word is a verb, okay? And if it is a verb, does it belong to مزيد فيه or does it belong to مجرد. Okay, that's the check that you have to do. So keep in mind, if you see يا ضمة, okay, أوي, if you see يا ضمة, or if you see those extra letters, like here we have learned حمزة is an extra letter, we have learned شد is something extra, and today in group 3 ألف is something extra. So if you see these extras, if you see يا ضمة, okay, يعني مضارع beginning with a ضمة, it's مزيد فيه. Okay, close your eyes and say it's مزيد فيه. أوي sound. Alright? So that's how you go through the elimination process. Once you have figured out that this is مزيد فيه, then you do the check. Which group does it belong to? Group 4, group 2, group 3. Right? Then you figure out the root letters, go to the dictionary, find the meaning, and that's it. Your work is done. Okay? Alright, so that's the elimination process, and we're gonna do some practice. Okay, so here we have aslamtu, the first one. Okay, aslamtu, same thing. I'm gonna ask myself, alright, is it a noun? Does it look like a noun? Does it have alif lam? No. Does it have tanween? No. Okay, so noun cancelled. Okay, is it a particle? Do I even need to ask this question? No, it's not a particle. What remains? A verb, right? In the verbs, is it mujarrad, okay, or mazid? Okay, let's take a look at this one. Okay, what does it look like? Aslamtu. Aslamtu sounds like madi because of the ending over here, right? And hamza is the hint that it is the extra to the root letter seen lam and mim. Okay, these are the root letters. The ta ending is part of the madi scale. Okay, it's part of the madi scale. You can have your basic madi and mudari charts, and you can see where aslamtu plugs in, and you will see it plugs into where fa'altu is. Okay, does aslamtu sound like fa'altu? No, because there is something extra. There is something extra than fa'ain lam, which is hamza. And which is that group that has hamza as the extra? Group 4. Okay? So you go to the dictionary, you look at seen, lam, mim, and then you look at group 4. Okay, I'm going to go to the dictionary here. Let's go and I'm going to search. Where's the search thing? Oh, okay, sorry. I'm blind. Okay, here. So, seen, alright, seen, lam, and mim, okay? That's a root letter, okay? So I'm gonna press okay here, see where it takes me. The dictionary has brought me here, okay? See, Salima. Salima is what? So it's giving, remember I told you last time that it's gonna give you the mujarrad. So it's giving you the mujarrad, okay? A is the, mudare, okay? Salima, yaslamu, okay? And then the masdar is right there, okay? So let's go through this paragraph. Remember I told you the first paragraph is all about the verbs, okay? So let's see where I find this one here, okay? Do I see any Roman numerals anywhere? Oh, sorry, I went too far ahead. Sorry. Here, okay. So you see two, there's two also, okay? Which means what? If you look at Salima, it means to be safe. In Mujarrad, it means to be safe. When you plug it into group two, it sounds like what? Salama. What is the meaning of Salama? Let's see. What does it say? To preserve, keep from injury, protect from harm, right? Sallallahu alayhi wa Salama. What is that Salama? This is group 2. Okay? Light bulbs, right? So, Salama, yusallimu tasliman. We always say this, right? When we hear Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, God knows how many times in our day we keep saying it, but it is right there. It's part of your daily vocabulary. Sallallahu, Salla, Salla. If you see Saad, Lam, Shad, and Alif Maqsura, that is also group 2. Okay? Sallallahu Alaihi wa Salama. So Salama, what are we asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do? To preserve, to keep him, to protect him from harm, all of that. Okay? So that is Salama, alright? Then the next thing that we are here, see, it said to grant salvation over here. The dictionary also mentions when it comes in the context of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it means to grant salvation. All right, so that's basically the, this is from where you get it. Okay, sallama amrahu ilallahi gives you different examples and all of that. All right, so that's group two. Now see group three. Okay, seen, lam, and meem. If I take the root letters and I plug it into fa'ala with the alif, how will it sound? Salama. And what's the meaning of salama? To keep peace, right? To make up with someone. Salama yusalimu musalamatan. Okay, so that is the meaning, not very commonly used, but it is there in the dictionary. And then what I want to see is, where is the group four here? It should be there. I don't know, it's not pulling up here. Let me see if it pulls up here. Yeah, got it. So if I continue, yeah, it's not showing me group four, though the examples are over here. I don't know where that page went, but you know, I'm sure physically if you take a look at it here, I'm not able to play around with it much, but this is, see, so it shows group five also. If you plug in seen, lam, meem, we've not learned that group, but that's when you know the basic form, you will know how to plug it in, and then you get the meaning. So the idea is, what I want to tell you here is, you just have to figure out how to extract the root letters, okay? And identify what group it belongs to. If you are not able to memorize the entire chart, that is okay, though I prefer that you do it. But if you're not able to, it's okay as long as visually you are able to plug it into the chart. Okay, just have one Madhi chart and one Mudhari chart constantly in front of you. Okay, and yes, the flow is the same, it's just that the harakat and the additions that keep changing, right? Otherwise, the flow is the same for both. So this is one tip that you can utilize until you have memorized. Okay, so here, that was the example that I wanted to give you with us, with Salima, the way it plugs into the different roots, right? Okay. All right, now, so we did aslamtu. Okay, now let's move on to the next one, which is, look at this one, nasrun. Okay, nasrun. Does nasrun, okay, is it a noun? I have my tanween check. It's a noun. Don't even think about anything else, right? Go to the dictionary, plug in the root letters, and you're going to find the meaning, which means help. Right? Okay, so then I'm going to move on to the next one. You have yukabbiruna, third one. Okay, yukabbiruna. Is it a noun? Absolutely no. Okay, is it a particle? No. All right, what is it? It has to be a noun. It has to be a verb. Now, if it is a verb, is it mujarrad? Okay, or is it mazid? Oo, e sound, not mujarrad. Has to be mazid fihi. Okay, now I'm going to eliminate the mudare. I'm going to eliminate the endings of mudare. Okay, what is remaining is kaf, ba, and ra, right? These are the three root letters with the extra, which is shad. What group does it belong to? Group two. Kabbara, yukabbiru. Let's go to the dictionary. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to type in here kabbara. Okay, it's very easy to install the Arabic font in your phone or in your, sorry, here, cancel. Okay, here we go, kabbara, here. Why isn't it typing? Sorry, it's not here, okay. Then we have kaf, ba, and ra. Got it. Okay, kaf, ba, and ra. Okay. Okay, so here it is. Sorry. Kabbara. Where is it? Here. This is where it is. See? Kabura. It's giving you the mujarrad form. Okay? So, all that tension, unnecessary. It's all here, right? Kabura. That's the mujarrad look. And then the mudare will be a U sound, right? Kabura, yakburu. And what's the masdar? Kaburun. Alright? And what does it mean to exceed in age? So it's giving you the meaning for the mujarrad form. Let's see where it is. What's the meaning when we move into the mazid fihi? So see, number two over here, to make great. Kabara يُكَبِّرُ تَكْبِيرُ. Alright, to make great what? Allah's name. Alright, so to make greater, bigger, larger, and enlarge, magnify, enhance. It gives you all those different meanings. Some of it doesn't even make sense anymore, but you get the you get the sense, right? Then you see if I put it in group three. Okay, if I take those root letters and if I plug it into group three, kabara, right? Kabara, it means what? To treat with disdain, to treat with haughtily, meaning to treat haughtily, meaning to be arrogant, basically. That's what it means, mukabar, okay? Mukabara. And let's see number four, okay? Here, akbara. Okay, when I number four, if I plug it into akbara, it means to consider something great. That's the difference. Kabbara, okay, to declare something to be great. And then number four is to consider something great, deem significant, regard as formidable, to praise, laud, etc. All that meaning comes in number four. And number two, again, to make great, to make bigger, all of that. All right, so here, simple. I hope you are feeling a little bit more relaxed and not as tensed, okay? It's, we will do these practices every class, inshallah. So every class there will be at least six words that I will do with you. So and it will be a mixed group, so you're able to like go through it all and refresh, right? Alima, here, alima, this is what? Is it a noun? No, there's no alif lam, there's no tanween. Is it a particle? No. Is it a verb? Of course it is a verb. Now in the verb, whether it's mujarrad or mazid fihi, it should be so easy, right? It cannot be mazid fihi because it does not have anything extra. I see ayn, lam, and neen, and the alif is part of the scale, right? It's the ending of the madi. So here, okay, this is mujarrad. I go to the dictionary, I find the meaning for alima, which means to know, okay? And alima, it places in the second column, right on the top, third person. If you lift the veil, there's a huma sitting underneath it, all right? And the translation will be, they both knew, okay? So that's another thing you have to figure out, okay? You have to know what pronoun is sitting under which verb, because that is going to be the doer. And what is the pronoun? What is that pronoun? Ending is the hint. So alif is the hint for dual, right? Alif is the hint for dual, while alif is the hint for plural, home, all of that, okay? All right, next we have yu'alimu. So see, alima we have, now we have yu'alimu. Now you can tell me in your sleep also, right? U, E sound, okay, has to be mujarrad. I'm not even gonna go through that first step, second step. Is it a noun? Is it a particle? Because we're pros now, okay? Yu'alimu. So here, ayn is first root letter, lam is the second root letter, meem is the third root letter, okay? And then I have the u e sound, it begins with a dhamma, so that is group four. Alima, yu'alimu, okay? The mazid fihi. So alima means to know in mujarrad, and alima yu'alimu means to inform someone, okay? You can play around with the dictionary. Now we have ya'alamu. What is this one? It begins with a fatha, okay? It has the three root letters, all right? Has to be mujarrad. This one, sorry, has to be, I made a mistake here. This is mazid, okay? This one has to be mujarrad, okay? So you have yu'alimu because it has the ya dhamma, it has to be mazid fihi, and ya fatha, all right, same root letters, ayn, lam, and neen, has to be mujarrad. So there you go, you did three, okay? Hopefully this has given you some confidence, all right, that it is not all that difficult. It's again, and I like it how some of you, like, you know, post messages in the group, in the comment section to encourage others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your efforts, reward you for what you're doing for yourself, and reward you for what you're trying to do for the others, right? We're all in this together, subhanallah. We really need serious students of Arabic language so we can carry this forward. There's so much need for this, whether it is at the adult level, whether it's at the youth level, the kid level, every level, this interest needs to be revived, right? We cannot be running away from it anymore, okay? All right, so now let's look at the chart. I'll just go over the chart with you just so that you know how the chart flows, okay? So we did group three today. We're introducing group three, and it is the fa'ala, fa'ala, fa'alu, fa'alat, fa'alata, fa'alna. The alif, it is the group that has alif as the extra, okay? Fa'alta, fa'altuma, fa'altum, fa'alti, fa'altuma, fa'altumna, fa'altu, fa'alna, فعلنا. Shift to the مضارع. يفاعل يفاعلان يفاعلون. تفاعل تفاعلان يفاعلن. تفاعل تفاعلان تفاعلون. تفاعلين تفاعلان تفاعلن. أفاعل نفاعل نفاعل. Okay, and then we have the command verb. Where do we construct the command verb from? From the second person. Same thing that we did in مجرد also. You just get rid of the beginnings of the مضارع, right? Throughout, you get rid of the beginnings, and then you make the ending light. The singular becomes second. The noon drops. Okay, everywhere except for the feminine. Okay, can I pronounce it without bringing a hamza in? Yes, it says fa'il. Okay, then we have, see, look at over here. Fa'il, fa'ila, fa'ila, fa'ilu, fa'ili. Oh, sorry, there's a typo here. Fa'ili, okay, and then fa'ila, and then fa'ilna. All right, so that's pretty much it. You constructed your command, and this is the noun form, okay. So مجرد, مزيد فيه, remember, has a noun form also. This is the اسم الفاعل, okay? اسم الفاعل, and this is the اسم المفعول. اسم الفاعل, doer, I've written as active participle and passive participle. You will find this in many textbooks, but what active means is the doer, okay? What passive means is the object. Okay, so then مفاعل مفاعلة مفاعلان مفاعلتان مفاعلون مفاعلات. You plug it into the Muslim on chart basically. Okay, if it's a mean dhamma, remember it belongs to the mazid fihi family. All right, so that's the entire chart, and we're going to do some practice verbs from group 3. All right, let's take the first one as shahada. You can see it? Okay, shahada. There you go. All right, shahada. All right, sorry, I wrote it in the wrong column. My fault. Okay, here. So this should come here, okay? Shahada. Alright? Shahada. Yushahidu. Okay? Shahada. Yushahidu. Masdar. This is what you have to remember. Shahada. Yushahidu. Mushahadatan. It has to plug into mufa'alatan. This is what you need to memorize. Mufa'alatan. Okay, instead of fa, ayn, and la, you're going to plug in sheen, ha, and dal. That's basically what you're going to do. You're going to take the three root letters, whatever the three root letters are, you're just going to plug it into the place of fa, ayn, and lam. Okay, so we have mushahada, and it has a second one also, right? That is shihadun, though this is not used at all. Okay, but I'm just writing it for the sake of practice. Shihadun is not used. All right, there's one that is commonly used, and I will come to that. What is the amr? Look at the mudare. Okay, get rid of the ya, make the ending light, and we have shahid. Okay, ismul fa'il. Again, just look at the mudare if you get confused. Just put a meem dhamma there. Okay, it will be what? And you follow the pattern of mudare. Okay, mushahidun. Okay, ue sound, mushahidun, and ismul maf'ul will be mushahadun. Alright, ua sound will make ismul maf'ul. So shahada, the meaning of shahada is to witness someone doing something. Okay, to witness someone doing something, that's the meaning of shahada. Next, let's take jahada. Okay, jahada. Alright, jahada, yujahidu. Okay, yujahidu, jahada, yujahidu. It means to struggle, to strive. Okay, and what is this? What's the masdar? Mujahadatan. Okay, jim ha dal. Okay, here, just plug it into this. Jim ha and dal. All right, and you get mujahadatan. Oh, what's the next one? The other masdar is what? Fi'alan. Right, so if I plug jim ha and dal into this, what will it sound like? Jihadan. This is your jihad, learning Arabic, okay? Jihadan, okay? So this is mujahada is used, but jihadan is, of course, both of them are used. In this case, you see both masters being used, okay? Again, you'll find the meanings for this in the dictionary. All right, and then the amr is what? Jahid, okay? And then mujahid, you know now the name where it comes from, mujahidun, okay? And then mujahadun. Mujahid, the one who is striving. Mujahid, whatever you are striving upon or for. Okay, mujahad. Mushahad, right? Whatever is being witnessed. Mushahid, the one who is witnessing. Shahid, it's command. Witness, right? And then mushahada is just the act of witnessing itself. So these are the meanings. I just quickly went over it. We're just going to do two examples in the interest of time. And now we're going to come to our application for Surah Ra'd, the second, before we conclude the class for today. All right. Simple. Again, you're going to look at each of these words, right? And you're going to try and ask yourself, is it a noun? Is it a verb? Is it a particle? And once you have identified its type, then you apply the properties that are specific to it. So if it's a noun, you try to find out the TGNS, type, gender, number, and status, right? So we have Allahu-Ladhi, okay? Allah, of course, this is noun, Lafzul Jalal. Al-Ladhi is Ism Mawsool, okay? Ism Mawsool is what? It's a noun. Remember the seven types of proper nouns, right? Refresh your memory. Ism Mawsool, Al-Ladhi. So Allah is the one, and anything that comes after Al-Ladhi, just to refresh everybody's memory, everything that comes after Al-Ladhi is describing the noun before it. Allah is the one. What did he do? Okay, رَفَعَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ. Okay, he is the one who, so رَفَع is what? What is رَفَع? رَفَع sounds like دَرَسَ فَعَلَ, so it's the فَعَل. Okay, and if you lift the veil, we have هُوَ sitting underneath it. Okay, so رَفَع means to elevate. Allah is the one who elevated the skies. Okay, بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ. B is what? Particle. Ghayr is what? Special mudaf. Okay? And all, that's why it's amadin. If I were to ask you, why is it amadin and why isn't it not amadun? Right? Because ghayri is acting. Why did it become ghayri? Because B... Okay, let me erase this. Hold on. Here. So, if you look at this one, B is acting upon ghayr, okay? Because it was ghayru. Alright, it was ghayru. So B acted upon ghayr, made it ghayri, okay? And then ghayri is acting upon amad, alright? Because this is, ghayr is considered a special mudaf, or you can call it jar, does not matter. But know that ghayr makes the noun jar, right? So B is acting upon ghayr, ghayr is acting upon amad, okay? بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ, without any pillars. He's the one who elevated the skies, right? He's showing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is basically showing his power. He's basically doing a halaqa. The halaqa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it runs in the nature, right? We don't need to sit inside a masjid. We don't need to attend a class. If we have an open mind, if the mind is engaging the universe, you will see Allah's signs everywhere in the universe, right? So بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا تَرَوْ, you have not done this kind of a verb yet, okay? So I'm gonna leave it, all right? But this is a verb for sure because it begins with a ta, okay? It's a verb, and this is the attached pronoun to a verb, okay? You see it, thumma is particle, okay? Istawa, all right? Istawa is a verb which you have not done, so I'm just going to move over. Then he rose, ala al arshi, this is jar majur, you've done. Okay, jar majroor. Okay, he rose. This one you have not done, so I'm going to put a cross on it. Over the arsh, right? Wa is a particle. And, oh come on, sakhara you have done. Now you know what sakhara is, right? It is mazid fihi tu. Sakhara yusakhiru taskhiran. So whenever you come across the mujarrad verbs, just do the sarf sakhir, okay? Sakhara yusakhiru taskhiran, sakhir, musakhir, musakhar. Okay? So sakhara means to subdue. If you go to the dictionary, it will say to subdue, alright? And he subdued he made subservient the sun, okay? Ash-shamsa, this is what? Noun. Okay? Ash-shamsa, and then well, qamara, wa is particle, okay? This is again noun. Qamara, you can do the TGNS. Kullun yajuri liya kullun, okay? Kullun, this is noun, okay? Kullun, it has a tanween. Everything, each and everything, kullun yajuri, ya, okay? Begins with a ya, it is a mudari. Is it mazid fihi or is it mujarrad? Jim, ra, ya. Is there anything extra? There's nothing extra. So it's mujarrad. Okay? It means to run. Everything runs its course. Li ajalin musamma. Li. What is li? So I'm going to break it up for you over here. Li, harf jar. Okay? Ajalin. Okay? Ajalin is noun. Okay? And then Musamman, musamman. Okay, you see, musamman, meem dhamma, automatically, meem dhamma, mazid fihi. Okay, what do you think the root letters are? Seen, meem, and seen, alif maksur is actually a ya. We'll do that. These are the little complicated forms of verbs, but they're very easy. Inshallah, once we finish everything, I'll go over these briefly. Okay, but it has the shad. Okay, it has the shad, so it's group two. You know it's group two. Go to the dictionary, the word itself is there, you'll find the meaning. Okay, so li, actually it was ajalun, right? It was ajalun, all right? But because li came along, which is harf jar, acted upon ajal and made it ajalin. Li ajalin, musamma, for an appointed time. Appointed time, what is the meaning? Appointed time, what kind of a construction is it? Sifa masur, appointed time. This we'll talk next class. Why is it li ajalin and then it is musamman? Sifa masuf are twins, right? And I'm pretty sure some of you are going to ask me this question in the comment section. I'm going to go over it tomorrow, next class, inshallah. Okay? Everything runs its course for an appointed time. All right? And then what? Yudabbirul amra. Yudabbiru. Yudabbiru. Remove the ya. Dal, ba, and ra. Extra shad. Group two. Dabbara yudabbiru, to plan. He plans the matter. Okay. Yufassilu. So see, all the group twos are coming here. Fassala, yufassilu, tafsilan, fassil, mufassil, mufassal. Right? So yufassilu, fa, saw the lam, extra shad. So group two. Yufassilu, ayati. Yudabbiru means to plan the matter. Yufassilu ayati, meaning he makes clear the signs. Okay. Why does he make clear the signs? Meaning everything that is there in the universe, right? These are there to, for us to make clear the signs. Signs of what? Signs of his existence. What? لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ. So that you, لَعَلَّ is sister of inna, okay? Attached pronoun kum becomes the ism of لَعَلَّ, okay? لَعَلَّكُمْ, everything, بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ. So that, perhaps you, about the meeting with your Rabb. Bi liqai. Let me do this one. And then we will conclude today's lesson, inshallah. Okay? Here. Bi liqai. This is, analyzing is one of my favorite things, okay? So you have bi liqai. There's so much happening over here. It's so easy. You have bi, right? Bi is harf jar. Okay, B is harf jar. It's acting upon liqa'i. All right, liqa'i. Now, liqa'i, meeting. It means meeting. Okay, what up? Meeting of. Automatically, you know this is an idafa construction. Okay, because the meaning of of is coming. Even if you don't figure out, B liqa'i. This one does not have alif lam. It does not have tanween. Okay, when it does not have alif lam and it does not have tanween, you're supposed to look at the noun after. This is all we've done it before, right? I'm just refreshing this for you. You're supposed to look at the noun after. If it has a kasra, okay, if this is light, does not have alif lam, does not have tanween, okay, does not have any one of the ending combinations with noon, and the noun after is a kasra, okay, noun after ends with a kasra, idafa, okay. This is idafa. So this is wa liqa'i rabbi. Okay, this is one idafa. And then rabbikum itself is another idafa construction. Your rabb, showing possession. Attached pronoun with a noun is always an idafa construct. Okay, the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he's saying in this ayah is the reason he's showing you all these ayahs and he's clarifying it, and the sun, the moon, all of that runs its appointed course, is for you to show, like, everything has its appointed course. What makes you think that you don't have an appointed time? What makes you think that you are going to continue forever? If everything in creation is going to come to an end, if everything is moving, progressing, right? If everything is progressing towards its appointed time, then me and you, we are also progressing towards our appointed time, and that is death. Okay? That is the message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about in this ayah. بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ يُوْقِنُونَ. Sorry, تُوْقِنُونَ. تُوْقِنُونَ. Okay, really quickly, last one. تُوْقِنُونَ. Eliminate the ta. Okay? Eliminate the wa noon. Okay, and then we have waw of noon. This waw actually is a ya. Just ignore that, but know that it is a ya قاف and نون. Okay, it's a يا قاف and نون. How did the يا become a واو? We'll talk about it towards the end of the verb session when we complete مزيد فيه. But this is something that happens. Okay, توك نون. Whenever you have يوك نون or توك نون, it's actually the spelling is actually يا قاف and نون. Memorize it. يا قاف and نون. It's like pneumonia. Spelling for pneumonia is what? P-N-E-U. I don't go crazy when I see the spelling, right? Because I understand these things happen in language. So same thing in Arabic also. It happens. It looks like a wow, but in reality, it's a ya. The real spelling is ya. Okay? So this one, because it begins with a dhamma, okay? The root letters are ya, qaf, and noon. Begins with a dhamma, group 4. Okay? Tuqinun, lift the veil. Who's sitting underneath it? Tuqinun, plug it on the mudara chart. You have antum sitting underneath it. You all will believe. So the translation, لَعَلَّكُمْ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّكُمْ تُوقِنُونَ. Perhaps you, after seeing all of this, after engaging with the movement of the sun, with the movement of the moon, with the movement of the moon, you will also realize like everything is moving along its destined path. Even I am moving along my destined path. And that will reassure me that the meeting with my Rabb is just around the corner. It can be around the corner. It can just happen anytime. With a flip of a second, things can change, and I could be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this, I will conclude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your efforts and you continue to grow. Inshallah, I will see you next week. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Salamun ala al mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Qad aflaha al mu'minun. الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين.